Hello, I'm R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in maternity, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and here I'm rendering exposition of Luke 13, Luke 14, verse 1 onward. Healing of a man on the Sabbath. One Sabbath, when he went to dine at the house of a ruler of the Pharisees, that means a rabbi, you know, they were watching him carefully. On Sabbath is a day devoted to do the philanthropic work of God, not for money, but philanthropic. So these priests that you see them in the dog collar, they are not working for God. They are not philanthropic. They are paid money. Without money, they won't come to the church. So they are working for mammon, not for God. They are number one hypocrites. And that's why you can't have gospel. And behold, there was a man before him who had dropsy. And Jesus responded to the liars and Pharisees, men of letters, saying, is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath or not? Because they are written that you do not work on Sabbath, work for money, but not for God. Is philanthropy. Philanthropy is not a work. It is free of charge. You don't get paid. It is representing the grace of our Father. So when you work for somebody on Sabbath, you don't ask for money. And you don't accept it, otherwise it won't be a Sabbath. But they remained silent. Then he took him and healed him and sent him away. And he said to them, which of you having a son or an ox that has fallen into a well on a Sabbath day will not immediately pull him out? And they could not reply to these things. Or there is no place for common sense. I was in 1983, I was watching television on teletext. There was a message that a house got on catch fire on Sabbath. And the house owners were Jewish. So they did not put it off. They rang their rabbi, our house is on fire, what shall we do? And he said, call the fire brigade. And then they called it, you know, not without the permission of the rabbi, because it is written in there that you can't have your own will. You have to go by the will of your rabbi, even when it catches fire, your house. And when I was in one of the interfaith meetings, when I mentioned this to a rabbi, he said, this thing happens in Israel every day. House catches fire on Sabbath, they don't put it off, they call the rabbi. So tightly they were bound by the laws that they were not allowed to use common sense. And common sense is Holy Spirit. Because those who are natural men, because the intake of the rabbi is natural men, children, once-born children. They are engaged in prayer and fasting. And for them, Yahweh is alienated. He is in heaven. He is not on vision. They don't know that God. They don't know the God which is spirit. They only know Heavenly Father, Yahweh. And that is in heaven. as you see in your prayers, our Father in heaven, that is Yahweh, not our Father which is inside me. This is the temple of God. My Father is inside me, is living, he is not dead, not imaginary. That's why we call Yahweh a demiurge God. Yahweh of this nature. Our Father is supernatural, greater than natural Father. And they could not reply to these things because they had no spirit. So that is why Jesus came to deliver spirit or oral Torah to the people, so they can think themselves and act themselves and give their own account to God. They do not need to rely upon the Rabbi. In this dark age is the age of Christ. If you don't have Christ in your heart, then you are dead, spiritually dead, and there are many of them. They know that this is the temple of God, but they do not know that the priest of the temple of God, this one living one, is not a priest that sits in the brick-built temple like Rabbi. He is a royal priest. Royal priest is Christ. So in my heart is the Christ, and it is the Christ which is making me to speak. So unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel. That's why Jesus said, you know, those who have ears, let them hear. This food you eat with this mouth, and it come out from the other end, and you don't want to touch it, it's smelly. The food which Jesus has given us, living bread, which is his word, we eat it with this ear, this is the mouth. This is eating the flesh of Jesus. After eating it, we take it to our heart and digest it. We think over it, what Jesus has said. Then bring it from our own mouth in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our Father, and this is called drinking the blood of Christ. Jesus came to glorify our Father God, not himself. And same, we also glorify our Father God, not ourselves, our Jesus. We honor him, honor me for his knowledge which he has imparted to us. He has introduced to us our Father, and those who have perceived Jesus have perceived our Father. What is natural, you see. Nature, you see with your two naked eyes. What is not natural, invisible, soul, that you perceive. So unless you are capable of perception, you cannot understand gospel. Holy Spirit is nothing else. Holy Spirit with small s, which is spirit of man, is nothing else but common sense. Holy Spirit with capital S is extraordinary sense. So letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So if you exercise spirit, then you get life. Otherwise, you are dead as those Pharisees, Lucy were. They were not working, or these doctors even today, you know. They are Jewish doctors. They will sit in their home on Sabbath, do next to nothing. They can cure people. They can do philanthropic work. No, they want money. Nothing without money. So our Father God blesses you.